Hello everybody, let's talk about the solidification of metals. The solidification of metals and alloys is an important industrial process since most metals are melted and then cast into a semi-finished or finished shape. In general, the solidification of a metal or alloy can be divided into the following steps. Step 1, the formation of a stable nuclei in the melt. Second one, the growth of nuclei into crystals and the formation of a grain structure. The shape of each grain acquires after solidification of the metal depends on many factors, of which thermal gradients are important. The formation of stable nuclei in liquid metals. The two main mechanisms by which the nucleation of solid particles in liquid metal occurs, and they are, first one, homogeneous nucleation, and second one, heterogeneous nucleation. Let's talk about homogeneous nucleation. Homogeneous nucleation is considered first since it is the simplest case of nucleation. Homogeneous nucleation in a liquid melt occurs when the metal itself provides the atoms to form nuclei. Let us consider the case of a pure metal solidifying. When a pure liquid is cooled below its equilibrium freezing temperature to a sufficient degree, many homogeneous nuclei are created by slow moving atoms bonding together. Homogeneous nucleation usually requires a considerable amount of undercooling, which may be as much as several hundred degrees Celsius for some metals. For a nuclei to be stable so that it can grow into a crystal, it must reach a critical size, a cluster of atoms bonded together that is less than the critical size is called an embryo, and one that is larger than the critical size is called a nucleus. Because of their instability, embryos are continuously being formed and redissolved in the molten metal due to the agitation of the atoms. And let's take the figure. So this is the first figure of for solidification, and this is the liquid, most of the part are liquid, and this is the formation of nucleus. So there is one nucleus, another nucleus, so these are the nucleus, small things, and most of the liquids. And after some time, some crystal forms, and although most of the parts are liquid, and finally we get the solid material, and these are the grains, and these are the grain boundaries. And let's talk about the heterogeneous nucleation. Heterogeneous nucleation is nucleation that occurs in a liquid on the surface of its container. Insoluble impurities and other structural material that lower the critical free energy required to form a stable nucleus. Since large amounts of undergoing do not occur during industrial casting operations and usually range between 0.1 to 10 degrees Celsius, the nucleation must be heterogeneous and not homogeneous. And there is a figure, and the upper portions are the liquid, and there is a solid portion, and there is a nucleating agent. And this is the angle del, and del is the contact angle. For heterogeneous nucleation to take place, the solid nucleating agent must be weighted by the liquid metal. Also, the liquid should solidify easily on the nucleating agent. Heterogeneous nucleation takes place on the nucleation agent because the surface energy to form a stable nucleus is lower on this material than in the pure liquid itself. Since the surface energy is lower for heterogeneous nucleation, the total free energy change for the formation of a stable nucleus will be lower and the critical size of the nucleus will be smaller. Thus, a much smaller amount of undercooling is required to form a stable nucleus produced by heterogeneous nucleation. And finally, thank you for being with me.